at the Fredericksburg Area Museum. We're going to go check out the Jane Howison Beale Diary. Do it. I'm at the Fredericksburg Area Museum, and I'm here with Sarah Ernst, who is the collections...
I'm the curator of collections.
Curator of collections. So she handles all the cool stuff at the museum. We got to talk later, too. I want to find what are the coolest things, and I want to get into them and tell the stories. There's so much here. So right now, though, the story we're telling is of the Jane Howison Beale Diary. So here it is, the original. And so, Sarah, if you don't mind opening it up for me. This diary was finished in 1862. She started it in 1854. And after the Battle of Fredericksburg, in December of 1862, that's when she had her last entry into it. There's the cover, just like it is on the actual copy that I have of it. So this book was, I'm gonna sit down here. Again, Jane Howison Beale was born in 1834, one of 12 children, and they lived in the James Mercer House, the yellow house on Charles Street, and one of a dozen children. And at 19 years old, she married Mr. Beale, who was a widow. He was 20 years older than her, and he already had 8 children. So she took on and became the mother to several, many of them were her own age. But then she had 8 children, but then together, they had 10 children. And then when she was still in bed because of a hard pregnancy, hard birth of her 10th child, her husband died. And then a month later, her mother, who was helping her take care of 10 children, died also. So then this is why she started writing her diary, because she was in such a depression and didn't know how to cope, because it was 1854. 10 children. So she started teaching girls at her home, and she also took on boarders at her home. And then, guess what? The Civil War came along. So then she wrote about the hardships of dealing with being in this town that in America was right on the border of the North and the South. Even though Richmond is the capital of the Confederacy and Washington, D.C., the capital of the Union, in one sense, this is right smack dab in the middle, and the Rappahannock River is just this mark of here's the North in Falmouth, here's the South in Fredericksburg. So just an amazing book, definitely worth a read, and I hope you check out the documentary I did about this diary that my daughter, Abigail Voss, narrated. Just an amazing story. Sarah, if you don't mind coming over, there's one page, and I just want to read some of it from the actual book. And so on December 11th, it's I don't know if you want to easily flip through or not. I know it's very, this book is 160 years old. She had such great handwriting.
Mm-hmm, she really did.
So it's, you know, in the actual, it's what's here is, I wonder if they have the dates on here.
This is May 26th.
How do you know that?
May 26th.
There it is. Okay. Interesting.
But I don't know if that's the date that she's talking about or if she's referencing. This is something about someone's being released by death.
June 3rd.
Still June 23rd.
Not sure if you keep looking, or if not, no problem. So on December 11th, she left town as everyone, here it is right here. Everyone left town. You mind if I put my finger here? I just want to keep it open. Okay. Everyone in Fredericksburg, all the families left town because the Union was just about to cross the Rappahannock River to attack Fredericksburg. That same weekend, 18,000 soldiers died. There was 120,000 Union, and there was 80,000 Confederates. Her house was smack dab in the middle. She left town a week before with all of her children and stayed in someone's house who she didn't know. But then one of her sons had a high fever, and they were sitting there a week. She didn't know what to do. She said, I'm going back to my own house to get my son well. Then December 11th came. And then I'll start reading here because it was in the morning. She says, "We were aroused before day by General Lee's signal guns, but not knowing their special significance, we did not hurry ourselves until Martha, our chambermaid, came in and said in a rather mournful tone, 'Miss Jane, the Yankees are coming. They have got two pontoons nearly across the river.' Before we were halfway dressed, and the heavy guns and the enemy began to pour their shot and shell upon our ill-fated town, and we hastily gathered our remaining garments and rushed into the basement for safety." So they're in the basement now, and this was pitch black. And I'm going to jump ahead now because I know this day so well. So her pastor, Pastor Lacey, whose brother owned Chatham Manor, which became the Union headquarters right across the river. If you've never seen or been to Chatham Manor, it's an amazing house on the other side of the river. But he's with them. He's the only adult male with her. So they start reading Psalm 23. Again, in most of her diary, she always turns to the Lord to just for strength, for perseverance, for understanding of what's going on in her life. So they start reading, he's reading, Mr. Lacey was still with us, and commence in solemn but tender accents repeating the 27th Psalm as we all knew it, and we heartily responded to each verse as the words, "Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear." These were upon our lips. We were startled from our seats by the crashing of glass and splintering of timber close beside us, and the first impulse was to rush the dark closet near the wood cellar, which, accompanying a central position, had no windows and presented two thick walls towards the firing. But before I had moved half a dozen steps, my youngest son, a boy of 10 years, fell against me with a cry, "Oh, Mom," struck. And by the aid of the candlelight, as I looked down, I saw that his sweet face was as white as the wall. Anyways, just an amazing thing of you're in the heart of battle. You've been part of this war now for over a year. They already came into town in April, and now the Union was attacking again. I think they had 170 cannons pointed at the town. Later in the, also in this part of the story, her house got hit by cannons many times, the house that still stands today. And at around 5 in the afternoon, her brother John came upstairs and came to the front door and screamed, "You gotta get out right now." She was still in the basement. She came up from the basement. She was blinded because she could not see. It was so bright out. She was just, they were in pitch dark listening to all this cannon fire. And the Union troops that she was able to see, though, were coming up the street toward her. They got into a carriage. The horse went right up to Sunken Well Road, and it left, got out of town to the same house that's just outside of town, which is now Route 3 or Blue and Gray Highway, and stayed there for a couple more nights. Her kids actually went to Lee's Hill, where General Lee was stationed, the next day, where the battle was on Marie's Heights. And that's another thing. All of this is like a movie, like it's not a real story. But Jane Howison Beale didn't want this story to be told. It was just in her diary. It was hidden for 109 years until in 1972, Barbara Willis, a local historian, heard the story, went to Jane's brother's John's house, Brayhead, which is still there. His relatives still lived there. They knew about this diary. She went to Charlottesville, found it, copied it. They HFFI, Historical Fredericksburg Foundation, Incorporated, made it into a book. I found it. I read it. I was blown away. And now it sits here at the Fredericksburg Area Museum. Boom. Know your history, people. This is amazing. Learn it and live it and appreciate it. So I'm going to have Sarah now come close this up. But this was just an amazing thing. I was so blown away by this. And I was sit at night like, I can't believe this is real. And then when I found out it was here, I thank you so much. I thank Barbara Willis for finding this. I befriended her, I was talking to her on the phone. She was 87 years old, and sad to say, she passed away 2 weeks ago. She was not able to see the documentary I made, but I'm going to happily show it to her husband once it's complete. Know your history, enjoy it, and love it. Till next time, thank you.